Hello and welcome to this video series about the rehabilitation after a rotator cuff repair. This video series consists of four parts, which include life rules, advice, and exercises that are important according to science. Hope you find this video series interesting and it will contribute to a speedy recovery.
The exercises in phase one include passive movements of the operated shoulder to increase mobility without too much force acting on the operated area. The first phase starts after the 2 weeks of strict immobilization in the sling. During this phase, the exercises that are performed require a low activity of the muscles. During this video, muscle activity is indicated by the abbreviation MVIC, which in phase one should be lower than 15%. Before we start with the exercises, it is important to know that during the exercises, you should make sure that you do them with respect to the pain and do not exceed its threshold. Phase 1 is the protection and early motion phase. The goal of this phase is to restore the mobility of the shoulder. And exercises in this phase of recovery have an MVIC of less than 15%. The first exercise is the pendulum exercise as described by McCann et al. In the year 1993. According to the systematic review by Edwards et al. In the year 2017, this exercise should be performed with care. Place the hand of the unaffected shoulder on a table, bend over, and then let your affected shoulder hang relaxed. It is important that you do not use the affected shoulder to initiate the movement, but allow it to occur by moving your legs and upper body. During this exercise, you can swing your arm forward, swing it sideways, and make clockwise and counterclockwise circles. Keep in mind that the affected shoulder remains relaxed while doing this. Incorrectly performed pendulums, especially large pendulums, tend to generate more supraspinatus muscle activity in the shoulder, which is not allowed at this phase of the recovery. Exercise 2 is the forward bow, as recommended by the systematic review of Edwards et al. In the year 2017. And described by Uhl et al. In the year 2010. This exercise generated a low MVIC of both the supraspinatus and the infraspinatus. The forward bow is performed by placing the hand of the affected shoulder on a table. Step backwards using your legs while your hand is maintained on the table. While doing this movement, you bend towards your waist. This will put you in a forward bow position. Walk back towards the table and repeat this exercise. Exercise 3 is the passive flexion in supine position, as described by studies by Gaunt, Uhl, and McCann. This exercise generated a low MVIC of both the supraspinatus and the infraspinatus. During this exercise, it is important that the non-operated side does all the work. In this example, the left side is the non-operated shoulder and the right side is the operated shoulder. Lie on your back with the fingers of both hands intertwined, with unaffected arm helping the affected side to rise and make the flexion movement. Exercise 4 is the towel slide exercise as described by Jung et al. In the year 2016. This exercise generated an MVIC of 8% in the supraspinatus and 4% in the infraspinatus. To perform this exercise, sit in front or next to a table and place your hand of the affected shoulder on a towel on a table. Maintain contact with the towel while passively sliding your upper body forward until you notice that the pain will stop it from moving forwards. By getting your upper body back in upright position, you will return to the starting position. According to the study of Jung et al., the shoulder angle could reach at least 117 degrees without a significant increase of the MVIC. Variations of this exercise can be done with the arm pointing inwards and pointing outwards. These variations also generated low MVIC activity in the supraspinatus and the infraspinatus. Exercise 5 is the washcloth press-up exercise, with the hands close together as described by Uhl et al. In the year 2010. This exercise generated an MVIC of 3% for the supraspinatus and 7% for the infraspinatus. To perform this exercise, you should lay down in a supine position and mimic a bench press movement, holding onto a towel with the hands close together. Extend the arms up and down again. Perform the exercise guided by the pain in the shoulder. A variation on the towel press up is the one with the hands apart. This variation also generated a low MVIC activity in the supraspinatus and the infraspinatus.
Exercise 6 is the supine bar-assisted external rotation, as first described by McCann et al. In the year 1993.
This exercise generated an MVIC of 3% in the supraspinatus and 12% for the infraspinatus. The aim of this exercise is to improve the external rotation of the shoulder. To perform this exercise, lie on your back with your elbow of the affected shoulder at 90 degree angle, resting on a small rolled up towel slightly away from your body. Use the stick to passively push the palm of the affected side away from the unaffected side, up to a maximum of 30 degrees in phase 1. In phase 2, you should be able to perform a 60 degree external rotation. During this exercise, it is important to let the affected side be led by the unaffected side.
The last exercise is the standing variation of exercise 6, as described by Jung et al. In the year 2016. This exercise generated an MVIC of 3% of the supraspinatus and 9% for the infraspinatus.
To perform this exercise, stand in an upright position with a towel rolled up under the armpit of the affected side and keep your elbow tucked in at your side. Initiated from the unaffected side, you then rotate the affected shoulder externally to a maximum of 30 degrees in phase 1, according to a study by Park et al. In the year 2007. According to the systematic review by Edwards et al. In the year 2017, the shoulder can be externally rotated towards 60 degrees at the beginning of phase 2. It is important to let the affected side be led by the unaffected side during this exercise.